Okay, we're going to do a bit of driveway work. So there's our product, bitumen. This area had, you could call it bitumen rot. A lot of leaves over a long time had fallen there, and you know, I just apply it with my hand. You'll see the technique soon. And then I put a cover over it, usually a plastic, a cheap, thin drop sheet with something over the top of it, just so you can bring the car over if you want to. And I usually let that sit at least a couple of days before I drive over it. I don't necessarily remove the covers straight away. We can see here, this is the area we're going to do, and then I'm going to spread over there, and there's a few low points throughout here. There's one there, here, and there's a crack, probably a tree root or something through there. We can see the dish there. Okay, so with the video, we'll probably just concentrate on here. That's tapered in because I'm going to bring a new bag and meet up with that. However, one thing I've noticed about this bitumen is don't feather the edges in. Leave an edge. So in other words, the height is pretty much dictated. It's dictated by the it's probably bluestone crushed rock inside it, so you can make that as your base to regulate your thickness. But just leave it, and as the car or over time, it'll just blend in with the rest of the bitumen. So I'm talking about how to finish off the edge along here. So just leave that the same thickness. Okay, well, I'll get my knee pads, my gloves. I've used these a number of times. They've got the bitumen on it. It doesn't matter, so long as the inside and around the edge is clean. A knife to open the bag. You want to give it a sweep or make sure it's cleaned. You may want to use a high pressure water cleaner, which is what I did for over here in preparation. I've just swept it today. But it's actually harder than you think to get rid of leaves off the bitumen. So it involves a fair amount of sweeping. Okay, well that's it really. So let's get on with it. Before I forget, it's a good idea to leave the bitumen in the sun and start a little bit later when the bitumen in the bag has warmed up. So you need to work fairly fast, but I've got the coverage I want. That's the work I want done, and I'll just do the patching and I'll show it later. Okay, next we'll tap it down with a bit of pine sleeper. Okay, it does compact down a fair way, so I'll continue doing that to the entire surface. Okay, another name for this stuff, of course, is asphalt. Okay, so I've spread it out. Is it perfect? No, it's not perfect. Probably needs a little bit more there. Maybe this could be a little bit wider. But, you know, it's okay. I'm not an expert. I have done some of this before, but not much. But there was a bit of work in that. But it's just a matter of taking your time, making sure it's level. Get your gloves and just scrape them across different directions and it'll fill in. Tap it down. And what we'll do now is cover it up so that it can be driven over. As I say, I like to give it 2 days to cure. The edges aren't necessarily blended in. As I say, it does like to have, a 10mm edge on either side. So there's a new asphalt now. This stuff's not cheap. This is about $38 a bag. And that's $3 a bag from there to there and to here. And these three patches here, that's three bags. And remember that there was already a bag and a half or two bags along here. So it's very, very expensive. It is crude oil and crushed rock. Okay, so as I say, you can see the low points here and here and here. There's a low point that has to be dealt with down there. You don't want puddles on an asphalt driveway. So that's this other one is just here. You can see a rise here, so it's just this area here. So okay, let's cover them up. Okay, so there's the drop sheet. You'll probably recognize that if you've done handyman work or painting or plastering or drywalling. So the drop sheet's down. That's just so that whatever you use as a cover it won't stick to it. Okay, so let's put the covers over. I've got two old Hessian old rugs. I actually picked them up when I was driving a garbage truck, and they've been priceless over the years, so I'll put them down over the asphalt. Okay, they're the gloves. You might recognize what sort they are. They seem like pretty thick, some type of hide. I find them to be good, and I can reuse them. I'll just wrap them up in this plastic wrap and use them next time. So, look, that's what I do. There may be other ways, or some people may not even worry about it, but I do find that the new bitumen could stick to the tyres. Okay, so that's what I do. I've got some good size drop sheets, and I can pretty much drive over that straight away. Okay, and I've got a separate one down there. So that pretty much finishes this bitumen video. I hope it helps or inspires some ideas. Please like and subscribe. Over and out.